Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which Hive, Sqoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. As we have successfully created the Sqoop job, let us understand how to run this. We have to use a control argument called as exec. Then we have to pass the job ID to run this Sqoop job. To get the list of jobs, we can say Sqoop job hyphen hyphen list and hit enter. It will show all the jobs that are created so far. As of now, we have created only one job, which is nothing but import underscore orders, and this is nothing but the job ID which we can use as part of Sqoop job exec. That being said, as we have seen earlier, we can say Sqoop job hyphen hyphen show and give the job ID to get the details with respect to this job. You can see the JDBC connect string, the table which we are trying to import, the username which is used to connect to the database, which is nothing but readel underscore user, the password file with the location, the HDFS warehouse directory into which the data needs to be imported, HDFS delete target directory, so that if the target directory already exists, we just want to overwrite and hence it is set to true, so and so forth. You can actually review all the information which is specified while creating the job. Also, we can actually review this location which is specified as part of the HDFS warehouse directory. As we have mentioned, HDFS warehouse directory, there will be a subdirectory under this location by the source table name, which is nothing but orders, and hence we should be able to run Hadoop FS hyphen ls, paste this and then give the table name, which is nothing but orders. The directory already exists and you can see the list of files also here. As we run this Sqoop job, all these files will be gone and a new set of files will be added to this as the data is imported. As of now, the date is 2019 May 20th. It will be changed to a different value once the import is done. So let's go ahead and run the job. We just have to say Sqoop job hyphen hyphen exec and then we have to pass this job ID to it. Now hit enter. It will connect to the source database using the credentials which we have specified as part of the job with the password file and then import the data into this target location, which is nothing but this one. So once the import is done, we will run Hadoop FS-ls once again on it and then we will see if data is imported or not. Now the job is successfully executed. Whenever we rerun the job, it will just replace the target location with the new set of data. You can run Hadoop FS-ls, paste this path and hit enter to see if the new files are created or not. You can see that the date is 2019 May 20th, timestamp is 556. Earlier the timestamp was 858. So this is how you should be able to run the Sqoop job. However, if you want to change the behavior of the Sqoop job, there is no way to alter. You have to delete and recreate. If you say Sqoop job hyphen hyphen help or Sqoop help job, you will get the help of the command. You can see that we are able to create the job, list the jobs, execute a job and delete the job. You will not be able to alter the job behavior by changing from overwrite to something else or anything that is specified as part of the job while it is created. So make sure that you have to delete and recreate if you have to change the behavior of the job by adding any control argument to it. If the job is created as expected, you should be able to execute by saying Sqoop job hyphen hyphen exec and by passing the job ID to it. Typically we will be scheduling using cron or any other standard scheduler to actually schedule this job once it is created. As we have demonstrated creating a simple job and executing it, now let us understand how to actually take care of incremental loads using the jobs. Jobs is very effective to perform the incremental loads. It will actually store the information that needs to be retained for subsequent runs somewhere and it should be able to catch up from wherever it was stopped earlier. So by incremental loads, we should be able to capture the delta from the source, and once we understand how to do that, we'll come back and try to use Sqoop job to actually plan for the incremental loads. We should be able to do incremental loads without jobs also. However, we have to keep track of the information which is required to perform the subsequent incremental loads. With Sqoop job, it is taken care automatically for us.